So, Faith, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me on, Alex. It's a real honor. And I appreciate you helping to spread our message of how much democracy is under siege. So I saw just last week you played some of the clips of what's been happening here north of the 49th in Toronto. So I'm running for mayor. And Alex, I have to say, there are actually more than 30 candidates. And I have been polling in the top three since the day I announced my bid to become mayor. In fact, my polling numbers are higher than all 32 people underneath me combined. And yet these folks, these opinion makers and gatekeepers, rather, of the status quo are inviting everyone onto their stage except for me. Why? Because my message tilts at windmills. It's no nonsense. It puts public safety above political correctness, and it questions the professional politicians and political elite that would sooner turn our city into an Agenda 21 playground for criminals, where we now have a higher murder rate than New York City's. So there, our very first debate was about the topic of the arts. Okay, this is something that liberal fancy pants care about, but Joe Sixpack at home, frankly, doesn't give a damn about. Because he can't afford his house, he can't afford his taxes, he worried that his kids are going to get shot up by stray bullets in the parking lot, he's worried that his dog is going to be stepping on, you know, these injection needles in the middle of the park. But they have to talk about, you know, the arts fancy pants stuff going on downtown. So I thought that this was a bit of an injustice. And so while I maybe wasn't invited, that wouldn't stop me, a taxpaying, freedom-loving citizen of this once great city, from getting up on top of that stage. And that's exactly what I did. As you can see there, I made a little quip about how I must have lost my invitation in the mail and introduced myself as Faith Goldy. And automatically, the liberal sheep in the audience began bawling at me and booing me. And really what I wanted to do was show that they weren't just censoring me, but indeed the 5,000 people's names who I had brought on that signatures on that petition that you see me handling to the little leprechaun troll who was hosting the debate. And then police quickly escorted me off. But as they did so, I reminded them that we are indeed the only campaign that's looking to work with our police and empower them to keep our streets safe again. Because in this era of political correctness, regrettably, we've said that everything that the cops do is racist. And so these guys have become handcuffed while our criminals are able to walk free in this city. And what this has now done, Alex, is this has created the first domino and now a tsunami of events. Shortly after I was dragged off stage by that police officer and the security guards, and by the way, I'm pretty sure that they're new voters now for the Faith Goldy campaign after hearing what we're about. Shortly after that, we had our paid-for ads banned from TV. These were very milquetoast, sensible ads. Then thereafter, this morning, we were supposed to go to another debate, which we weren't invited to, but the whole debate has now been canceled because they're so afraid of us. And Alex, I'm going to break some news right here for you. Three of our top accounts that have been supporters of us, or even if not supporters, just free speech advocates who have helped shed some light on what we have now been enduring, this almost collusive bedfellowship between the mainstream media and the political elite. Three of our Twitter fans, I guess you could say, and free speech loving citizens in this city, they've now been suspended from Twitter. So there is an all out assault on our little campaign for mayor. And it's just.
Well, that's because if we get a smart, pro free market type, pro Trump, beautiful, smart woman in, that sends shockwaves across the world. They're everything they. Everything they're doing is to try to stop something like you because you're everything they wish they had. And that's happening to all conservatives, all nationalists, all over the world. Twitter, Facebook, Google, as you know, are concertedly trying to stop populist nationalist movements everywhere. And I had just read the local paper, you know, saying that you were polling number three out of the six major candidates. I had no idea that there were 30 plus total. That is amazing.
Yeah, it's quite insane. But look, we know what this is all about, Alex. You are very much the godfather of this new surge against freedom lovers. Censorship happens when powerful people feel threatened. And now with the democratization of data, with the boom of things like InfoWars and other alternative media, they have lost their stranglehold on the narrative. And people are starting to come to and say, hold on a second. We tried it your way, globalists. We tried it your way, Marxists. And the status quo just isn't working for us. We want our old freedoms back. We want fair elections back. We want to be part of the democratic election process again. And well, the guys in power don't like it. And here's the crazy part, is that it's essentially leading to a Streisand effect, wherein they think that they're censoring me, but now I think we've got over 8,000 names on our little petition. They're not just censoring me, they're censoring thousands of people who are with this campaign, and tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands perhaps, who are watching this. I mean, that one little clip that we did of us just walking across stage has, I think, well over at least 250,000 views already. And so our movement is growing. The more that they try to silence us, the more people are starting to pay attention, because they're saying, what is this forbidden fruit? Well, I'll tell you, it's not the forbidden fruit of evil and lies. The forbidden fruit in today's culture of death and lies is truth itself. And, you know, you were saying just before the break, Alex, you know, you wear it as a badge of honor that we're being persecuted. Well, I'm a Christian woman and I'm devout. And, you know, Jesus said, blessed are they that are persecuted for my name's sake, for there shall be the kingdom of heaven. And that's what we're all about here, baby, on the Faith Goldy campaign. We're about capital T truth. We're about justice, and we're about that for all people in this city who want in on this freedom train. And that's what makes us so dangerous.
And you should be the winner out of nowhere, number three against 30-plus other candidates, and they won't let you on the stage. How outrageously authoritarian is that? And it shows they were so arrogant before, but now with populism and Brexit and Trump, and from Brazil to areas of Asia, nationalist candidates are in the lead, so they're getting stabbed, they're getting shot, they're getting blown up. They're not just getting censored. This is all over the world. The left, allied with the Chi-Coms and with the EU and with big tech, are taking the gloves off. Don't they know historically that blows up in their face?
Massively. But look, here's the thing, Alex, is that these people have been preconditioned. Because we have removed things like free speech from the public space, free speech from our universities, etc., what happens when your mouth and your mind stop working? Because, of course, without free speech, there's no such thing as critical reasoning. So you got no mouth, you got no voice, you got no brain, you got no more critical reasoning. All that's left are fists. And as we saw with the presidential candidate in Brazil, knives are now coming out. I mean, people who meet me on the streets who are part of these Marxists, you know, these sheepish hordes, they think that they're fighting a literal Nazi, when really all I want to do is debate with them. And they will soon realize that our arguments are better than theirs.
But they are the dumbest of the dumb, controlled by the most evil of the evil, funded by Soros and others. So they have been whipped up into this, like, LARPing, like it's a video game, and you're just a bot that they're there to kill, when you're a real person and not what they said, where they dehumanized you. Faith Goldy, stay there. We'll be right back. You know, I'm sitting here listening and looking at Faith Goldy and just admiring everything she does, and her eloquence makes me feel good to know there's other smart people out there taking action. But at the same time, I catch myself getting angry, because this is real authoritarianism. This is real oppression. This is real censorship. And it's by the left in universities all over the world and right here in my own nation, and now spreading out to the city councils and the legislatures and the capitals, where if you even criticize radical Islam or anything else, the system censors you and then jails you, and it just goes on from there. And then I was reading earlier, we'll get to some of it later, about the city festivals they're having in San Francisco that children are taken to, where people defecate in each other's mouths and cut each other and bleed all over the streets, and how beautiful it is, and how they're teaching us about consent because they're the moral good people that crap in each other's mouths. Now, I'm sorry to be talking to the audience like that and having a nice, young, beautiful woman here talking like that in front of her, but that's what's in the San Francisco Chronicle today. In fact, it's somewhere in my stack. I'll never find it. Please print it for me again. And that's their moral leadership, this culture of, we're going to kill your babies, but Brett Kavanaugh is a rapist because we say so with no proof. And then, oh, and this lady, smart and successful TV and radio host, and with no funding or no establishment behind her, she's number three in all the polls. My God, she'll win. My God, they'll take back power from us. My God, we don't want a good Christian, hardworking, smart woman as mayor who will actually turn the crime-ridden city around. No, we want the hellish places like Toronto and San Francisco and Detroit. What is it, Faith Goldin? We'll play the video in a moment with audio of you basically grabbing victory from the jaws of defeat. What is it about the left that they destroy everything they touch? Because every blue city in the world and every blue country, socialist country, if you call it blue, used to be called red, is a hellhole. They take beautiful, good places and within a decade create abject nightmares. What is it about these people?
Well, I think right at its core is the fact that they are motivated, frankly, by the forces of evil. But quite outside of that, in order to move forward with their socialist, that's really what it is at the end of the day, agenda, they have to create crises so that way an ever-expansive government can offer the solutions. So what that has led to is a complete attack on the things that have made the West a healthy body. That includes our moral civic consensus, our family structure, simple things that have helped to keep the West great. And what they do is they attack these things in ways that they can, which have been largely through the long march of the institutions, our schools, our media, and our political establishment, so to manufacture this crisis. And then when we see that, well, mom and dad aren't together anymore, my house is in shambles, we don't know what's right and wrong anymore, we've got big billboards of rap stars with their you-know-what-sits hanging out right over top of schools where they're teaching these kids all sorts of perverse ideas before they can barely even spell library, well, then come on, mom and daddy state, help create a solution for us. So what they do is they run completely counter to all the things that have made the West great, which are really a foundation on, frankly, Christian tenets, things like personal responsibility, equality of opportunity, and freedom. And so I think that's why we see such a pushback. And I will say that the reason why they have become so much more militant about just engaging their agenda and achieving it is because the stakes couldn't be higher. Right now, for instance, in my jurisdiction, Toronto has become a sanctuary city to our self-professed feminist prime minister's crazy open borders policy, an undemocratic open borders policy. And they're shipping in these people by the thousands into Toronto shelters, while our guys who, you know, have been taxpayers, who might have an addiction, who might have a mental health issue, are left to struggle on the streets. So, you know, my Toronto first mentality and very bold, policy of just putting Toronto first, all of our taxpayers, which include our little homeless guys as well who need our help, it threatens their biggest industry right now, which is illegal migration into our country.
Gut level, what would you call this point in history we've reached, and where do you think we're going? I mean, I don't care what they do or what they say or what they do to me. I'm not going to stop. And the media spun this falsely, saying that Alex Jones is ready to die. Alex Jones says he's close to God, cryptic statements in an interview I did. And the individual was saying, how far will you fight? Will you ever back down? And I was saying, give me liberty or give me death, Patrick Henry. Didn't mean Patrick Henry was going to commit suicide. I would never commit suicide. What I was saying is, the more I get persecuted, the more I'm doing right, the closer I get to God, it makes me feel good at a spiritual level to be awake and to not be a zombie. Like so many people are, as my consciousness and my awakening intensifies, it's a good thing, and then I'm ready to go all the way. Just like Christians would not renounce Christ in Rome and got thrown to the lions. I'm saying I'm not going to renounce my faith. Doesn't mean I'm a Bible thumper either and in everybody's face saying I'm a perfect person. It means I love God. I love justice. I want to be close to Christ. I want to stand up for unborn children. I want to promote the right to self-defense. I know capitalism is the best system. I don't want our children being sexualized. It's simple. And these globalists and all these freaks want control of our lives. It's their world. It's their universe. And they twist and lie everything I say, everything I do. When I say I'm willing to die for this, it means just what I said. I don't want to die, but I'm willing to die. I'm never going to back down. I'm never going to give in. I'm never going to submit to these weird globalists and all of the satanic crap they're into.
Yeah, you know, you asked me what would you call this juncture of our history. I recall that Spengler talked about the seasons of civilization, and I do think that we're really in the fall right now. There seems to be this chill that is coming, but we, of course, are going to be the last blossoms that give the onlookers some sort of hope of what was once was and what could be. And I'm right there with you, Alex. You know, as a woman of largely Greek heritage, Molon Lave is imprinted in my heart and soul. I've got a fire burning in my belly, and I'm going to pursue truth and follow the facts wherever they lead. I don't care if it makes people uncomfortable, because by gosh, we're going to be a lot more uncomfortable in this snowball of lies as opposed to one that's led by the torch of truth. And Alex, can I give you some free advertising right now? So, Alex, you know how you said that you think that we're spirited and bright people that are part of our campaign? I'll say that the entire Felix and upper echelon of our campaign is heavily on brain force, and a lot of our guys are on healthy male vitality as well. So there's some free advertising for you guys.
Well, I'll tell you, I've seen your work, and it's amazing, and I am sold. I want you to be the mayor of Toronto, because I've been there before, and then I came back a few years ago, and it has really gotten crappy and looks like San Francisco. We're going to open the phones up. We want to talk to Faith Goldy, who's going to win in Toronto unless there's election fraud. And I think them keeping her off the stage, even though she's number three out of a field of 30-plus, has already blown up in their face. But what can we do down here in the U.S., and our listeners in Canada, to make sure these censors aren't able to stop this amazing lady? So Faith Goldy is really in third place out of 30-plus people. That's amazing, and they won't let her come to the debates. So she's engaged in real information guerrilla warfare, and we're so excited about that. Now, we've already rolled the video for TV viewers, but for radio listeners, let me play it with audio. This is her last week at the city-sponsored mayoral candidate event, and here are all these other people up there who are behind her in the polls, but she's not there. Here it is. And this morning, Arts Vote held the first public debate for mayor of Toronto. Faith Goldy is currently in third highest polling candidate for Toronto mayor. So why was she not invited to the debate?
Good morning. Sorry, I must have missed my invitation in the mail. My name's Faith Goldy.
Logan Choi. Let Faith speak. Let Faith speak. Let Faith speak. Let Faith speak.
And she delivers 5,000 signatures of people that want her to the debate. Here come the police to drag her out.
Let Faith speak. Let
now, they had an event called The Rhetoric of Donald Trump and Alex Jones this weekend, taxpayer paid for, shut down downtown on a big stage. I went there, and they were just shocked that I actually showed up, and they were smiling and smirking, and it was so enjoyable. They're openly discussing at the event how to shut conservatives off the internet. So that's the leftist answer all over the world, is that their fact checkers, including Charlie Weasel of BuzzFeed, totally discredited, he sits there and waves a magic wand and contacts media, contacts tech giants to have media removed. So he believes he is God, Faith Goldy. And they smile. They're so proud to be the modern authoritarians.
Well, that's the thing. And when you dig just beneath the surface of any of our enemies, the ones who are leading the charge, you realize that a lot of them are sick, twisted, and evil people. Look no further than one of the co-founders of the SPLC, who's quick to label everyone a racist and a Nazi. I'm pretty sure that he was doing sexually lewd things to his stepdaughter. You come here to Toronto, and there's people who are leading the charge against me who are in bed with the most radical elements of the jihadist movement here in Toronto. Our own mayor, who will be outgoing come October 22nd, he's campaigning at mosques that have called for unbelievers to be slayed one by one and for the, quote, filth of the Jew to be eliminated from their presence. By the way, one of these mosques is where the Danforth shooter in Toronto's Greek town, where his family attends. So these people are the sorts of evils that they try to accuse us of being, but this is the sort of world of subversion and censorship that we now live in, where what is truth is made to look like a lie, what is right is made to look like it's wrong and racist. And what we have to do is just to continue to frankly seek truth. And also, don't be afraid to sometimes let out what you think. Every single person I've talked to on this campaign, Alex, says, I'm voting for you, and everyone I talk to is voting for you. Don't be afraid to shout it from the rooftops. One of the things that I hear from all of my volunteers is faith. Your fearlessness is contagious. Folks have to remember that. We can all be leaders in our own lives, whether it be around the water cooler, our dinner tables, and our university classrooms. Having a brass pair is contagious, and people love that. And we have to remember also that our enemies, the guys at the top, are evil, but the majority of the flock are honestly soy boys. When I see my guys lined up beside, say, the incumbents guys along the same strip of sidewalk, they're just so low energy, our enemies. They just look so lame. They're losers. They don't even know why they're there. They're human automatons. Just someone flipped a switch and they started marching. Whereas our guys, they're fighting for truth. They're fighting for justice. And there's nothing that animates the human soul, especially in a time of darkness, like knowing that you are part of the light and you are part of the change that this world so desperately needs. So I'd encourage all of your audience, first of all, if you're in Toronto, come out to the ballot box, help spread a word, because God knows the mainstream media is not letting us get a word in edgewise. And for everyone else, let our campaign inspire you. I see life as a series of doors, and most of them are able to be opened. It's just a matter of timing. So find the time in your life to help, you know, so-called red pill your friends about what's happening.
Oh, listen, I'm totally sold. I was already familiar with your great work, but you are so eloquent, teleprompter-free, so on target. Toronto needs a mayor like you. They need a prime minister like you. And that's, again, smart, good-looking, great background, up against them. That's why they won't let you on the stage, because you're too effective, you're too on target. And, you know, you were talking during the break about you guys are going to pull fluoride out if you get in. Harvard studies admit it causes cancer. I mean, they are so horrified of you. In closing, you were also, don't give us any inside baseball, but you were saying you guys have got a lot of third dimensional information warfare ready for them.
Alex, we're on to 4D chess over here. Our opponents do not have plays for the sort of war games we are going to be unleashing on them every day until October 22nd, E-Day.
So it's energizing you. They're trying to suppress you. It's not making you submit. It's not demoralizing you. And that's what they don't get. It's that we came to change the world. We're not coming to try to be their minions or get a slot in their system. We're coming to try to fundamentally change the world.
That's exactly right. They don't understand that we just get bigger numbers and more energized in our mission every single time they try to shut us down, because what we know that signals is that we're more powerful and more on track than even perhaps we had any inclination of. So it's all fantastic. And, you know, there's this, I think it's a Japanese warfare Aikido. You take the negative energy that your opponent gives to you and you use it back to destroy them. And that's exactly what we intend to do.
Oh, my gosh. I am so sold. Faith4Toronto.ca. Faith Goldy, you said you'll come back next week for 45 minutes
Absolutely.
Or so and take calls. We'll talk to you soon. Thank you so much.
God bless you, Alex. Thank you, my friend.
Oh, thank you. Well, I tell you, that is so exciting that she's got energy. She's got all of that will. She's smart. She's good looking. And they are so scared of those long legs and that brain all together in one package, because they claim they want powerful women. They do not want powerful women. Okay? They want to control and make women victims, not victorious like Faith Goldy. So I'm completely sold. I've been following her for a couple years, and the fact they're trying to suppress so many people is really making men and women like her rise up, every race, color, and creed, and it is a beautiful, beautiful thing. So they can't have her on the stage because, well, they can't deal with it.